Hi students, welcome to the session on motional EMF. Right, so whenever you want to learn about motional EMF, we have to bother about two things. Right, one is here magnetic field is kept static. So here the magnetic field is static and circuit is moving. Right, whereas in transformer EMF, circuit is static, magnetic field is varying with respect to time. So if you want to generate motional EMF, keep your magnetic field stationary, static magnetic field, and circuit should move. So what is motional EMF? It is the process of inducing EMF. It's a process of inducing EMF in a moving conductor. That is very, very important word. Inducing EMF in a moving conductor placed in a stationary magnetic field, placed in a static magnetic field or stationary magnetic field. So where we are inducing EMF, EMF is induced in a moving conductor. That conductor is placed in a magnetic field, the static magnetic field. This process is known as what you call motional EMF. What happens here is, here you see when area changes, when area changes, what will happen? Flux density will change, then flux will change, right? Change in flux induces EMF, right? EMF is equal to minus d phi m by dt. Clear? How? Hey, see, when area changes, what will happen? When area is small, the number of flux lines passing through, field lines passing through, that is less. So when area increases, more lines will pass. More lines means more flux. Less lines means less flux. Clear? So if you change the area, the flux will change. Change in flux induce EMF. Phi is equal to B into A. When area changes, flux will change. Right? Change area, flux will change. Change flux, EMF will be induced. This is the logic used in the an induction of motional EMF, right? So we will deal that now, right? So what happens when we move a loop, conducting loop in a static field B, right? EMF will be induced. That's what we know, right? We know that force on a moving charge is given by F is equal to QV cross B, Lorentz force equation. Right, since conductor moves, charge also moves, right? So we have to take force on a moving charge. We cannot use Coulomb force, F is equal to QE, because this is for force on a static charge. Here we have to bother with force on a moving charge, with the charge moving with velocity B in a static magnetic field. Velocity V with the static magnetic field B. Now we define a motional electric field. Right, so motional electric field E. What is motional electric field? That is given by, for static electric field is F by Q. Motional electric field is Fm by Q. So this, let us assume this is Fm, moving force. Right, so Fm by Q, that is equal to B cross B. This is what we call as motional electric field. Right, so now if we consider a conducting loop, right, and it is moving with velocity B, right, and it has more number of electrons, then EMF can be written as V EMF is equal to closed integral E dot dl. Already we know for a static charge, V is equal to E dot dl. Right here, EM dot dl, because it is talking about moving charge, so motional electric field only we have to take. Here we take static electric field. Here we have to talk about motional EMF. EMF is nothing but potential only. Okay, so motional EMF means we have to take motional electric field. Motional electric field is given by EM is equal to V cross B dot dl, V EMF. Right, that is equal to E dot dl, EM dot dl. This is one important equation.
Fine. Okay. So this motional EMF is also known as a flux cutting EMF. Flux cutting EMF. Why it is called flux cutting EMF? Because the, when area changes, it is, if area is vast, it cuts full flux. If area is small, it cuts less flux. So I can call that is a flux cutting EMF, right? That is a one more thing we have to remember. Next, this is a integral form, right? So integral form of motional EMF. Integral form of motional EMF. Why? So it is having an integration and it is talking about EMF, right? Next, we find a differential form. So we know that here, from here we will start EM dot DL, right? So EM dot DL is equal to what you get is already we derived this EM dot DL is equal to V cross B dot D. Fine. So now let us see, we apply Stokes theorem. So EM dot DL will become del cross EM dot DS. Fine. So it will be del cross EM dot DS. Okay. So similarly, if I apply Stokes theorem here, what will happen? Surface integral of del cross V cross B dot DS. How we got this? Applied Stokes theorem. Line integral is converted into surface integral. Here, here it should not be closed. It should be opened. So VM dot DS, right? So from this, what we understand, this indicates, so both are surface integral. So this indicates del cross EM is equal to del cross V cross B. Fine. This is what point form of EMF, sorry, motional EMF. Right. So this is what integral form of motional EMF. Right. So that is given by V EMF is equal to V cross B dot DL EM dot DL. Right. So these are all the two equations we have to derive for motional EMF. Okay. So I hope you understand both the equation, right? So we know we are having three different methods of generating motional EMF. First method, varying field and static conductor. What is that? That is what our Faraday's law, that states point form is del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T. And what is the another form? We know second form is E dot DL is equal to minus dou B by dou T dot DS. Second method is this method. This is transformer EMF. Transformer EMF. This is motional EMF. Here, what happens? Here, conductor moves, right? B is static. For that, we got this equation. What is the third method we will see now? Where both B varies with respect to time, and the conductor also moves. This is third method. So third method is a combination of first and second method. So we don't need to derive, we can simply add the result. So first we write integral form VEMF for static conductor and a moving field. What is the answer? VEMF is equal to E dot DL, that is equal to V cross B dot DL, right? It is dot. So VEMF is equal to, right, E dot DL is equal to V cross B dot dl. What is the, for this? It is minus integral dou b by dou t dot ds. So simple, integral form is summation of both the result. Similarly, what about differential form? Del cross E is equal to, for this one, it is minus dou b by dou t, right? And for this one, T emf, motional emf is del cross V cross B. So it is del cross V cross B. Fine, sorry, del cross V cross B minus dou B by dou T. Right, this is for type 1, del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T. For second motional EMF, del cross E is equal to del cross V cross B. Fine. So this is the equation for motional EMF, electromotive force induced by time varying flux. Fine. So these two equations, we don't need to derive the equation from the answers of type 1 method. This is a Faraday's law, I explained in another video. Type 2, I explained here. This is type 3. How we generate time varying flux? We can generate in three methods. All the three methods have been explained. I hope you understand. If you have any doubt, please ask me in comment section. Thank you.